Alan Jamal, Ashok Private Boys School, 11D.
Amr Issam, Ashok Private School, 11D.
Our project is about irrigation with using solar cells system. Our aim of this project is to supply water and electricity to the places which are far away from the power lines. And we can convince every farmer to be happy with their water and electricity too, without using a lot of money. As now we talk about the most important thing, which is the solar panel.
So in here we got a 45-watt PV solar panel, which is a polycrystalline type and A-class type, which converts the sunlight energy into electricity from the by the movement of electrons in silicon cells and by using the photons. So now we are going with our solar regulator.
The solar regulator has three main functions, as you can see. First of all, it tells us if the battery is charged. And the second of all, it tells you the amount of battery which has in the battery. And the third thing, it regulates the amount of energy and charge that goes to the battery. Imagine if we don't give it solar regulator. It will have a lot of charge, and it might have a lot of acid, and it will be ruined. And nobody has time to change the battery each week. And now we're going to change to the battery.
So in here we have a 12 volt 20 ampere per hour deep cycle battery, which saves our energy. And an example of it in a cloudy day, so we our solar panels couldn't get the energy or the electricity that's needed for working this system. This battery will automatically work and makes the pump to be work.
The solar pump is the second most important thing in this irrigation system, because it will convert the water from the far place to the place that we want. This pump, it is 1.7 ampere, 12 DC volt, and 28.3 ampere, which is good enough for our small thing. But if you have a big one, more than 5 ampere and more than 200 volts DC, and more than 300 watts, it will convert a lot of water. This is each minute is 4.3. The other one, each minute will convert more than 200 liters, which is very important and needed. And now we're going to talk about the inverter.
So we got a 300 watt solar inverter, which converts the DC direct current into alternating current. We are not using the inverter in this system because our pump is already on DC electricity. Thank you very much.
And the last thing we can show you, say this is the river, and we convert the water to the place we want. Thank you very much for your time.